Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Just wanted to do a quick review on the Ulanzi wide angle lens. Okay, so this lens did come with microfiber towels to wipe off the lens, two or three additional gaskets that you stick onto the lens itself for the thing to screw on the mount, and the actual lens itself. Now, for my very first thoughts of opening the box, what I did think was the lens cap looked kind of cheap. This lens cap here, it looked kind of cheap. But the overall lens, the build quality, everything, you could definitely notice a weight on it. So I'm not sure how that will affect the longevity of the Sony ZV-1's lens, because it does pop out when you turn it on. And as most of you know, for these point and shoot cameras, I believe the gears inside that make it pop out are usually just plastic. So because of the additional weight, it's gonna make it very front heavy. And I don't know how that will affect it in the long term. Obviously, I just started using this. Now, everything else in the box, very standard, very straightforward on how to install. Okay, now for the wide angle and how it works itself, as you'll notice here, we can see all of the bathroom door right here, and you can see the pillows and everything on my sofa in the back. Right now we are shooting on a standard stabilization mode. So the minute you switch to active, you're gonna notice it punches in a bit. When you're on standard stabilization, unless you have very steady hands, or maybe if you're on a gimbal or even a heavier tripod, you will notice some shake when you're walking around. So I do recommend switching to the active stabilization mode when you're walking around with the camera. But when you're doing talking headshots like this, you don't really need it, unless you do want that, but you don't really need to. You can just have it as regular standard, or you can just turn it off in all and it'll be even wider than this. Okay, so with that in mind, when you switch to active stabilization mode, it does punch in a bit, so I'm just gonna switch it out for you here now. All right, and we're back. This is active stabilization mode. As you can see, before we could see all of the bathroom door, but now we can't. A few less pillows on the sofa. The camera is arm's length distance away right now. My arm is straight forward right now. Straight, not bent. And you can see that it did punch in quite a bit. This will help you with your walking shots and everything, and it'll make everything look really stable. If you just have it as standard and you're walking around, the footage isn't gonna look great. It is usable, but it's not gonna look great. And depending on how picky you are with your footage, I don't know. I personally don't like it on standard when I'm walking around. Now, let's just get straight to it. Let's put on the lens, and keep in mind we are currently on standard stabilization mode, and just keep in mind the frames right now of the door. Okay, take off the lens cap, arm's length away, and right now we pretty much are looking at what the regular standard stabilization mode is at, right? Because you can see all of the door, you can see a lot more of my sofa, and I'm not as punched in like this, right? So you can notice a difference. Now, do I feel like you need this wide angle lens? It really depends on the user. If you're just buying out the Sony ZV-1 right now and you have it on active mode for stabilization, I think it's still decent. I think you can still use it. I certainly think I can still use it. I just bought this lens because after doing a lot of reviews, I do feel like I'd rather have the more range of view. And you'll notice the corners here are fairly crisp. There's no vignetting or anything, which is really nice, because sometimes when you mess with the distortion of the lenses, sometimes it does give you kind of like a fisheye effect, I believe. But yeah, everything looks really well. The autofocus is still on point. And yeah, so it really depends on the user. So right now I'm gonna switch to standard stabilization mode, and then that way you can kind of have a view to see how much wider it is now. Okay, so one second. Boom, It looks super wide, and this is full arm's length distance away. And it looks really good. If this is what you want for your talking headshots, you can definitely make this work. Like this will, yeah, this will definitely work. You can see my second door over there right now. Oh, this is my bathroom door. This is my office door. So wow, yeah, you could see a lot more of the space. So it works really well. It does what it's supposed to do. Now, one of the drawbacks, obviously, it being a point and shoot camera, majority of the time people like to put their cameras in their pockets. If you have this lens in, you're not going to be able to put it in your jean pockets, but I normally like to wear baggy sweaters or basketball shorts, and those pockets are usually fairly big, and you will definitely be able to put the camera in your pockets like that. I don't know very many people that would want to put it in their jean pocket because it seems kind of tight. Like, I don't even really like to put my phone in my jean pockets, but that's the only option I have. So keep that in mind. I don't think that's really a con, but you could also get like a little satchel for it. It does protrude quite a bit. And again, it is front heavy now, the camera. So make sure when you're twisting it on that it's on right. So yeah, that is my quick review. If this review helped and you do want to buy the camera, I have affiliate links down on the bottom. If you purchase it from those affiliate links, it does give me a little bit of kickback commission on the sale, but it has no additional cost to you. Tell me on the comments below on what you think about this lens. I think it's a worth it buy if you really need the wide field of view. But again, I think the camera itself without this lens, I think it's totally doable as well. So again, affiliate links on the bottom. And if this review helped, leave a comment below. Let me know if you're gonna buy it and why you chose to buy it, and if it's because I made you buy it. But yeah, thank you. And as always, have yourself a dang good day.